It's a familiar story. Wall Street tumbles and gold sets a new record.
Gold is something that governments can't really devalue.
As hot as gold is right now, timing is everything.
Recent roller coaster ride of our economy. The most stable investment with the greatest return is the acquisition of gold. The University of Pennsylvania's football team is not only rich with tradition, its wealth in gold dwarfs the rest of the Ivy League. The class of 2013 added to this wealth, bringing 3 gold rings in 4 years while returning the coveted Ivy League trophy to the place where it's most familiar, Franklin Field. This class compiled a 12-1 Ivy League record, playing at this historic stadium.
1, 2, 3!
Penn's most recent home win also came with the biggest prize, and it would be the last time this class would run out of the tunnel onto Franklin Field. The date was November 10th, 2012. The victim was Harvard. With a Penn victory, the Quakers were guaranteed a share of the prestigious Ivy League trophy. The Quakers under Bagnoli have had tremendous success against Harvard, beating Harvard 14 times out of 21 contests.
I think we challenge our kids to play their best game on the biggest stage.
The red and blue jumped ahead quickly after taking the opening kickoff. 2 minutes, 45 seconds, and 69 yards later,
Scott for the touchdown from 32 yards. Penn strikes first against Harvard.
Let's see what they do on 3rd and 2. It's a quarterback run.
He gets to 0. He gets minus.
The Penn defense kept Harvard guessing and off balance all day as the mighty Quaker rush got to the Crimson's QB 6 times.
Look out for behind. Down goes Chapel. 3rd and 18. Jeff Allen is in zone under pressure. Drop from safety.
Penn also dominated in the turnover category.
Plenty of time for Chapel. Airs it out and it's picked off by Dan Will.
Harvard's defense was no match for the Quakers' rushing attack.
Marsh has an opening.
Lyle Marsh had a career day rushing for 133 yards on just 27 carries.
A colossal pickup. Billy Ragone. Touchdown.
Penn took the win with a 30-21 decision as players and fans stormed the field.
So, well, hopefully we can take care of business next week at Cornell and win it outright. But again, we'll worry about that tomorrow and enjoy tonight.
I'm going to celebrate, and then tomorrow morning I'll be looking at Cornell film.
With their win over Harvard, Penn is, once again, an Ivy League champ. However, a loss at Cornell would most likely mean a shared title. Head coach Al Bagnoli and his teams have never shared an Ivy League title, and they're not about to start.
Come on now.
Penn clinched its 3rd outright Ivy League championship in 4 seasons, and 9th overall under Bagnoli, by downing Cornell 35-28 at Schoelkopf Field, boosting Bagnoli's record against Cornell to 15 victories in just 21 tries. Senior quarterback Andrew Holland, who had an impressive 67.3% completion rate, made his first career start against Cornell, replacing the injured Ragone, who suffered a season-ending injury against Harvard the week before.
Yeah.
It was a back-and-forth physical game from the start. Senior Jeff Jack barreled through the line for his eighth career touchdown, putting Penn up 7-0 early in the first.
Jack, up the gut. Jeff Jack is across and in for a Penn touchdown.
The defense stymied the Cornell passing attack, and Cornell's rushing game had little success. Lyle Marsh broke through the big red defense to find daylight along the Penn sideline and laced his way to a 55-yard touchdown, ensuring Coach Bagnoli's mighty Quakers do not have to learn to share. A total of 13 players from the 2012 Ivy League champion University of Pennsylvania Quakers were given all Ivy honors. Penn had five starters and six second team players selected. Senior offensive lineman Joe Bonadies helped anchor an offensive line that blocked their way to landing two rushers in the top 10 for the league.
Marsh has an opening. While Marsh cuts back.
Sharing the O-line with Bonadies was senior Mike Pinciotti and junior Christopher Bush, both named to the All-Ivy second team. This outstanding front five did not allow one sack in the Harvard victory.
What a terrific performance by the Penn Quakers.
Harvard is about to lose for the 14th time in its last 16 games here at Franklin Field.
Defensively, Quakers senior lineman and captain Brandon Copeland had a standout season.
First team All-Ivy defensive tackle on the first play is all over Chapel.
With five sacks and seven tackles for a loss, earning him his third career All-Ivy first team selection.
Caprio under pressure, Copeland's got him!
Third and 18. Chapel now in his end zone under pressure, a drop! False safety!
Senior punter Scott Lapano, who holds the distinction of having played in every Penn game over the past four seasons, and averaged a collegiate best 41 yards per punt in 2012.
The top punter in the league, Scott Lapano, booms one away, sends a beautiful high hanger coming down at around the 15. That one takes a dead roll bounce. That could be placed down at the 1 yard line. It is. What a punt by Scott Lapano.
Rounding out Penn's first team selections were junior defensive back Sebastian Jaskowski.
McBride is stopped in his tracks, leading the charge, Sebastian Jaskowski.
Jaskowski led the Quakers defense with 72 tackles on the season. And sophomore linebacker Dan Davis.
Dan Davis bearing down on him, and Davis collars him back at the 40-yard line. Yet another sack.
Get used to the name Dan Davis.
Chapel looking for somebody open, can find no one. And he is wrestled down by Dan Davis.
Second team honors also went to senior defensive back David Twombly.
That pass is picked off. Intercepted by David Twombly.
And senior running back Lyle Marsh.
Marsh is gone.
As well as junior wide receiver Connor Scott. And junior defensive back Dan Wilk.
Dan Wilk, number four, the cornerback, streaking in from the side, untouched for the sack. There's a man wide open, and it's Connor Scott for the touchdown from 32 yards.
sophomore kicker Connor Loftus, and senior quarterback Billy Ragone garnered honorable mention All-Ivy honors. Ragone was the most unrecognized and most dangerous weapon in the league.
Ragone's going to throw the left to a wide open Ryan O'Malley for a touchdown.
Ragone diced up opponents through the air and trampled them with his legs, combining for 21 touchdowns this year.
And there he goes, Billy Ragone. Touchdown.
Penn's offense in 2012 was an impressive 94% from within the red zone, leading the Ivy League. Penn scored on 29 out of 31 trips to the red zone, hitting pay dirt 23 times. Penn held opponents to 385 yards per game, with 130 yards per game coming on the ground and 255 yards through the air. Quaker defenders also recorded 12 interceptions, 4 fumble recoveries, and 19 sacks.
That man, Ross, Al Bagnoli's been here a while.
Well, he has. He's number one among active coaches in the Ivy League in wins, win percentage. In fact, his winning percentage is number one in all of FCS football. Right now, he's got to be considered the best coach in the Ivy League.
In Bagnoli's 21-year tenure, 12 times Brown has dropped to Penn. Penn has beaten Columbia 18 times. Yale has bowed to the mighty Quakers 15 times. Dartmouth has taken a back seat to Penn 17 times. Harvard and Cornell, as you well know, have been defeated 14 and 15 times respectively. That leaves one team left in the Ancient Eight, the Princeton Tigers. This so-called Cross River rival has yelled mercy 16 times in 21 games. This year would be no different, except for playing in front of a national audience. The victory extended Penn's win streak versus Princeton to 6 games. The 28-21 road win over the Tigers was a back-and-forth thriller.
Michelson to Wilson, double covered, and it's picked off in the end zone.
Ragone keyed the Penn victory, scoring 2 touchdowns, one through the air.
Ragone looking for a throwback, does just that. Touchdown, Quakers!
And one on the ground, capping off this fourth quarter game-winning drive.
Ragone, all day, touchdown!
The score put Penn up for good, 28-21. On Princeton's final drive, facing a third and goal with 30 seconds on the clock, senior linebacker Steve Leas from Pittsburgh, PA, poked the ball loose.
Loose on the ground, Penn pounces upon it.
And senior captain Brandon Copeland fell on the fumble to seal the win.
Are they going to say fumble? They will. Penn ball.
The Tigers' offense was intercepted by Quaker defenders 3 times.
Another deep ball. Climbing the ladder, attempting a pick.
The most damaging of the 3 picks came late in the game's fourth quarter.
Picked off, and Penn gets a score on defense. C.J. Mooney, the conversion.
We're thinking run. I was lucky enough that Danny Rick had pretty good deflection on the ball, and you know, happened in the right spot at the right time, and you know, took it to the house.
Both the offense and defense keyed on big plays and turnovers to wrestle their way to a tough win. In his 19th straight start for Penn, senior quarterback Billy Ragone is now 15-4 as a starter against the Ivy League, 3-0 against Princeton. This game puts Penn at 8-1 all-time at Princeton Stadium.
Quakers have won 6 in a row, 15 of 17.
This year, playing in front of a national audience 3 times, Penn won its 9th title under Bagnoli, with relatively few individual stars or stat leaders winning close games. This alone proves that Bagnoli and his staff's preparation and guidance are second to none.
Great funnel on two. That's what's messing him up in the pass game right now. They can't get funneling on two.
And the players' mental and physical toughness are the best in the league. Overall, this was a season that will be remembered, both in gold and in the men who made it happen. For some, it will be their last. It was a bittersweet sight to behold these seniors running out onto Franklin Field for the last time. But as the many greats before them, they will take their place in the Quakers' rich history, steeped in tradition and pride. Their pictures will be hung on the walls alongside the rest of Penn's championship teams for future Quakers to look upon and be inspired by. They will keep with them the lessons they have learned here for the rest of their lives, as they make way for new talent to take their place on Franklin Field.